This mountain is not so big. Between east and west, it's about 7 kilometers and 18 kilometers between north and south. This land price corresponded to the same price of whole United States in 1989. So now you understand, some people became super rich. It's called bubble economy period. Bubble finally burst in 1991, and many companies went to bankruptcy. And since then, our employment system has been changed very much. So before the bubble economy, most Japanese companies guarantee the lifelong employment. So if you belong to some company, you can work to the end of, you know. And about 40% of all Japanese workforces is part-time job worker now. So part-time job worker can get not enough money to make a living. Some people are like homeless. And it's very hard to pay house rent every month. So no house to come back. So they stay inside a McDonald's or internet cafe during the night time. And some unlucky girls, you know, it's very hard to look for a job because they don't have any address. So that's why finally they became their own prostitutes. So it's a very pity life. So in front of us, there is another public park. It's a Hibiya Park. Well, first...
This is going down to the elevator hall of the main observatory. お帰りの際には 大展望台1階より下りのエレベーターをご利用ください。お待たせいたしました。エレベーターホールでございます。 To go back down to the ground floor, use the elevator from the first floor of the main observatory.
お待たせいたしました。エレベーターホールに到着でございます。降り口は左側です。 しい。今まっすぐ向いた方向に跳ねたかった。あっち、あっち、こっち。今斜め右側にしながら行っちゃう。
Bustling with activity as one of the 53 main post towns along the old Tokaido trunk road. In the town today, you can still see the remains of the Hakone border checkpoint, built in 1619 by the Tokugawa shogunate to protect the area. We will soon be passing the second steel tower of the ropeway, which is 43 meters high. Causing fearful calamities like floods and epidemics. In the hopes of pacifying it, the terrified villagers offered up their small children to the beast. One day, a priest called St. Mungan, who was travelling through from Kyoto, heard about the dragon and the sacrifice of the poor children, and made up his mind to rid the lake of the dragon. St. Mungan built stone steps down into the lake and continued to pray there all day and all night. Until one day the guilty dragon climbed up the steps to repent its misdeeds. St. Mungan quickly captured it and tied it to a nearby tree, whereupon the dragon transformed into a nine-headed dragon god, which swore to protect the lake and the villagers. Since then, the villagers have offered red rice and sacred wine to the lake instead of small children, and there have been no more calamities. This legend is the origin of the lake festival.
Over there.
Nine.